I think one of the reasons we were toying with that actually as a title at one time is because some of the things that we advocate in this book are not common practices. And so we're asking teachers to think about those kids that are in their classroom. We're asking teachers to think about maybe bucking their own systems a little bit because, and I know Penny has talked about this a lot, this idea that sometimes we get overly focused on the standards and we lose sight of those children who are in our classroom. And in our talk yesterday, you talked a little bit about how each year is different.
Yeah, and I think we thought that the reason it is in our title is that teachers are out there teaching every year, and it is, you know, it takes a lot of courage to try something new, but I'm not sure that I would call it dangerous. But the idea behind a year of teaching dangerously was that we were exposing what could we fit in a school year. And I think that we both feel like it's a little more comfortable to say, do this. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to tell you exactly how, but I'm just going to say this would be a really good thing here. What if we instead said, this is what we did, even though we know looking back it wasn't perfect. And that felt dangerous for both of us.
Yeah, I mean, when we had extensive conversations about how we were going to approach our kids, you know, this idea that we came to this idea sort of philosophically that we were going to do some things that aren't done in a lot of secondary classrooms. And, you know, I think that is dangerous. I think it's dangerous. I think we both meet tons of teachers who give us a sense that they're locked in with, you know, other people telling them what to do with their kids. And ironically and sadly, I think a lot of times that the people who are telling them what to do with their kids are very far removed from their kids and removed from teaching and removed from the day-to-day realities of being in the classroom.
The teachers don't feel they have a voice. They don't feel they have agency in their work. And we were saying, we both work in places where we've been given the agency to decide what's best for our kids. So with our best thinking together, could we come up with a plan and then how what worked worked and how it didn't and then share it with teachers?
I also think it's dangerous too in the sense that even though we have a combined 66 years of teaching, should I say that publicly? That even though we have all these years of teaching, we're doing new things every year. We're not repeating the same thing. And I think we both get that charge and that energy from, from, you know, not exactly repeating what we did the year before. I mean, as we sit here now, we just did this complete new equity unit with kids and looking at book clubs through the lens of the issue of equity. That's not something we've ever done before.